You're watching PTS English News. I'm Stella too. Our first story today, the Central Epidemic Command Center recently loosened border restrictions, but capped the weekly number of inbound travelers at 25,000. And this resulted in an all-out battle between airlines to secure quotas.
The International Departures Terminal at Shangshan International Airport is virtually empty, with only a few travelers scattered around in the waiting area. A look at the international departure signboard shows that the only flight departing that day is an 11:30 a.m. flight to Japan's Haneda Airport. Many countries have eliminated border restrictions, but the number of flights hasn't returned to the previous level. Airfare has also become more expensive, dampening the desire for travel.
其实我是三月份买的，所以好像还好。我就是中间换一次班机，过对，就是好像第一班就误点6小时，然后那时候就是有赶快换票，所以就麻烦一点。拖那么久，然后又不是我要的时间啊，就先不做吧。
Many people are taking a wait-and-see approach. The Central Epidemic Command Center recently loosened the inbound quarantine requirement to 3+4. However, it capped the weekly number of inbound travelers at 25,000, leading to a battle between airlines for quotas. There are reports that people are stranded in Shanghai because they haven't been able to buy tickets to return to Taiwan, and they will need to wait until at least mid-July for flights to return. Some travel agents attributed this to airlines needing to conform to Shanghai's disease prevention policies.
在中国大陆的方式就比较特别，因为他们用清零的关系啦。像有的旅客昨天要回来，他人是在上海，但是上海航班从6月初开始就一直取消，不管是从上海浦东或是从虹桥开始飞，从几乎都没有。那个从上海要飞出来的，只有一般华航。那7月14号，搞不好这一班也会取消，5天至7天会提前告诉你，那你有办法去解决你的后段航班的问题。
Travel agents say flights to and from China are primarily carrying business travelers and students. A 737 aircraft only has about 180 seats, and flights aren't daily, so people are finding it difficult to get seats regardless of the class. Airlines will release seats if someone cancels.
The stipulation requiring travelers in domestic tour groups to have received 3 vaccine doses was canceled starting today. Well, now all that is needed is a negative result on a rapid test taken within 48 hours.
Now even people who haven't received 3 vaccine doses can join domestic tour groups and travel around Taiwan. The Ministry of Transportation and Communications has announced that people who haven't received their booster can join tour groups as long as they provide a negative result on a rapid test taken within 48 hours. If a member of a tour group tests positive during the tour, the remaining travelers won't be affected and can continue with their journey. Experts point out tour group members sit together on buses, share meals, and may even share a room. This means they are at as much risk for spreading COVID-19 as family members that live together.
同团的旅客，他那个接触的时间其实也蛮久的。他接触的时间说不定跟一般的家人一样，是不是同团旅行的旅客其中有一个确诊，其他的旅客得到感染的机会其实是蛮大的。这可以考虑一下，是不是也要有一些居家隔离的规定。
The domestic epidemic situation appears to be improving, but many children are still developing severe cases. A pediatric emergency physician posted on Facebook about his experience treating an infected child in mid-May. The child arrived with a fever, difficulties breathing, and croup. His sternum and ribs also sank when he inhaled. Luckily, he was intubated and treated in time, and his condition stabilized. He has already recovered and has been discharged.
声音沙哑，咳嗽像狗的声音。第三个就是说呼吸的时候会出现哮鸣。如果当变得更严重的时候，就会出现这所谓的胸凹，甚至说肋骨上的一些凹陷。Central
Epidemic Command Center statistics show the total number of children with severe COVID-19 cases currently stands at 62, including 21 with encephalitis, 12 with pneumonia, 3 with septicemia, 7 with croup, 12 with MISC, and 2 with comorbidity. 18 have died, including 5 at home. Doctors say vaccination can prevent severe cases in children, and all adults and children eligible for vaccines should get vaccinated.
Thai Power is looking at operating losses of 200 million NT dollars this year due to soaring fuel prices. It will convene a price adjustment review meeting on June 27 with expectations of a price hike being announced for July.
有望接理事长吗？我们要开大会吗？对对对，先等开大会。
The Chinese National Association of Industry and Commerce will elect a new chair soon, and current chair Lin Bofeng believes Taixing Holdings chair Thomas Wu will succeed him. Lin has been an outspoken critic of the government's plan to hike electricity prices for only major users, saying a price hike should apply to everyone.
制造业会出走，一定会出走。只涨到用电大户，那就是处罚用电大户，受政府处罚，我们就应该出走了。Lin
also says a maximum hike of 3% would not have any effect on Thai Power's financial problems, and a hike should be implemented in stages due to Taiwan's stifling inflationary pressure. Yimei Foods chair Henry Cao, meanwhile, says it is reasonable that electricity prices reflect costs, as electricity accounts for only a small percentage of corporate operating costs.
全部都不涨，变成电力供应亏损几千亿，税收的预算对经济也是不利的。Thai
Power says losses are piling up for every kilowatt hour sold, and consumption is rising with temperatures. The company is expecting energy usage to hit an all-time high on the 21st, which will trigger a yellow operating reserve margin warning.
大潭的互循环的大约74万呢，还在进行税修。中火的5号机还有林口的2号机有破管，今天的备转容量呢，略低于10%哈。Thai
Power says its price review committee will take consumer prices and fuel costs into consideration to come up with an appropriate adjustment. Now bringing some top stories from around the world. Dmitry Muratov, the co-winner of the 2021 Nobel Peace Prize, auctioned off his Nobel Medal for a record of $103.5 million to 8 children displaced by the war in Ukraine. A Japanese court ruled that a ban on same-sex marriage was not unconstitutional, dealing a setback to LGBTQ rights activists in the only group of 7 nations that does not allow people of the same gender to marry. The world's biggest gambling hub, Macau, began its second day of mass COVID-19 testing after dozens of locally transmitted cases were discovered over the weekend, with most businesses shut down but casinos remaining open. And now DPP candidate Lin Zijin actually said he intends to resign as Hsinchu City Mayor sometime in July and change his household registration to Taoyuan. Meanwhile, Kuomintang candidate Simon Zhang already finished changing his household registration to Taoyuan's Longtan district. And on the other hand, Taiwan People's Party candidate Lai Shenglin campaigned at Taoyuan Station today.
The Taoyuan City mayoral race is heating up. Democratic Progressive Party candidate Lin Zijin, who is currently the mayor of Hsinchu City, said on Facebook on June 20th that he will resign as mayor in July and switch his household registration to Taoyuan. He claimed that Hsinchu City's municipal affairs won't be neglected because of his departure or Deputy Mayor Shen Huihong's campaigning.
6月30号才会7+7的时间才会到，月初或月中左右了哈。 那我会提出辞呈，然后将我的户籍迁到桃园，来做这样一个参选的一个工作。Simon
Chang, the Kuomintang's candidate for Taoyuan City Mayor, completed the process to transfer his household registration to Longtan District on June 20th. When asked about Lin's resignation and his possible household registration transfer to Qingpu, Chang said he believes the city's people will make the right choice. He campaigned at the grassroots level on June 21st.
我在龙潭工作了12年，所以到龙潭把户籍迁过去是饮水思源的做法，没有什么安全牌不安全牌。Taiwan
People's Party candidate Lai Shengling campaigned at Taoyuan Station on June 21st and announced her Onward Taoyuan platform. She described the race as a showdown between political elite and the populist candidate.
这一次的战争好像是蔡总统跟朱主席的战争。那我要问，我们桃园市民要这样的一个高层战争来选择我们的桃园市的大家长吗？
Lai laughed when asked about when she will transfer her household registration to Taoyuan and where she will buy a house. She responded that her household registration will be in Taoyuan District, and a populist mayor would only rent, not buy.
On the other hand, Vivian Huang, Jiang Wang-an, and Lin Jialong are all promoting their family and housing platforms ahead of the year-end Taipei mayoral race.
Lin Jialong, who is pursuing the Democratic Progressive Party's nomination for Taipei City Mayor, says he will provide up to $200,000 to newlyweds for family planning, subsidies for egg freezing, and up to $160,000 in interest subsidies on startup loans. During a radio interview, Lin also said he wants to discuss the transition of Chiang Kai-shek Memorial Hall with Kuomintang's Jiang Wang-an. Lin also took advantage of the opportunity to promote himself as the DPP's most suitable candidate and called on the party to accelerate its nomination process. Taipei City Deputy Mayor Vivian Huang, who is expected to run as an independent candidate, says people's unwillingness to have children isn't just about money. With Huang having yet to announce which party she plans to represent, Zhang and the KMT City Council candidates are promoting True Blue.
我想这个问题啊，需要去问黄副市长，这是他专属的问题啊，我没有选择党籍的问题，我就是国民党提名的候选人，年底我就是代表国民党参选市长的选举。
As for Huang saying the city government already has a young-old residential switch policy, Zhang said implementation is more important than who came up with the idea first. Zhang has not responded directly to Lin calling him out by name, only saying he is proud to be a member of the Zhang family and he wants to transform Taipei into an international city that matters.
Thanks for watching PTS English News. I'm Stella Tu. We'll see you tomorrow.